Sweet hour of prayer, sweet hour of prayer, that calls me from a world of care and bids me at my Father's throne. Make all my wants and wishes known in seasons of distress and grief. My soul has often found relief and oft escaped the tempter's snare by thy return, sweet hour of prayer. Sweet hour of prayer, sweet hour of prayer, may I that consolation share, till from Mount Pisgah's lofty height I view my home and take my flight. This robe of flesh I'll drop and rise to seize the everlasting prize, and shout while passing through the air, farewell, farewell, sweet hour of prayer.
Good morning, Holy Spirit, for such a precious, wonderful day. Holy Father, thank you for your grace to pray this morning through the help of your Spirit. Through prayer, meditation, and singleness of mind, we praise you for invading our individual life with strength, insight, courage, sufficient for our needs. In Jesus' name, amen. Friends, God can rescue believers like Peter from the most difficult situations, as happened in Acts chapter 12. The Romans appointed Herod Agrippa the First, grandson of Herod the Great, to rule much of Palestine during this time. He persecuted Christians, killed James, and planned to kill Peter. Persecution now breaks upon the church. Why did the evil hand of King Herod persecute the church? As Acts chapter 12, verse 3 informs us, he possibly desired to achieve popularity with Orthodox Jews, so he decided to attack the Christian church and its leaders. He killed Apostle James, the brother of John. This pleased the Jews. This was an indication of the very uncaring and unsympathetic nature of some of the Jews. The evil heart of Herod led him to aim at Peter, the actual leader of the church. We thank God that there was a religious observance delaying his move to put Peter on trial. Peter was kept in prison and heavily guarded. And so Acts chapter 12 verse 4 informs us that so when he had arrested him, he put him in prison and delivered him to four squads of soldiers to keep him, intending to bring him before the people after Passover. His case seemed hopeless. Peter's case seemed hopeless. However, the church employed for Christians' secret weapon. And so when the believers heard that Peter was in prison, constant prayer was offered to God for him by the church. Acts chapter 12, verse 5. They learned what it meant to pray without ceasing. It would have been totally impossible for even me to develop a prayer life without first becoming acquainted with the Holy Spirit. It flows so naturally when you know Him, yet apart from Him, it is impossible to pray. The Holy Spirit will always change your prayer life. The church then continued to pray without ceasing, and this continual prayer was offered until the answer came for Peter, and he was delivered from Herod's prison by an angel of God. The chains fell off, and he walked out of the prison. Indeed, our God is the God of the impossible. When we consider the security of Peter's jail with 16 soldiers set to guard him, it was a miracle that he escaped. It is a great credit to the believers for praying and playing their part in interceding for Peter. God's answer to their prayers was prompt. Yes, at the nick of time, deliverance came supernaturally. All that Herod put in place to keep Peter gave way, and he was delivered from his confinement. In fact, this divine intervention by God on Peter's behalf was so miraculous and out of the ordinary that Peter wasn't sure whether or not it was happening. He thought he was having a vision. Just moments before his liberation, Peter had been sleeping, chained between two soldiers. Then suddenly, a bright light appeared in the prison, and an angel of the Lord woke him and said, "Get up quickly, Peter." And with that, his chains fell off. Then the angel of the Lord told him to put his sandals on, wrap his garments around him, and follow him. Not until he was outside the prison, walking on the street, did he realize what had really happened. Nothing is impossible with our God. That is what Luke tells us in Luke chapter 1, verse 37. Are you worried about the situation of the church in your nation, in your country, or about the COVID-19 health crisis that look hopeless? Or are you worried about certain personal problems that you are grappling with at this time of your fresh year? Be encouraged. God is aware of the situation, and as you prayerfully trust Him, He will send help to you at the right time. The believers in the book of Acts were able to pray without ceasing for Peter because of the presence of the Holy Spirit, and no security failed, and Peter escaped. Indeed, without the help and assistance of the Holy Spirit, this would have been impossible. This morning, ask the Holy Spirit to quicken you as you call upon the name of God. And more importantly, ask Him to quicken you daily, and He will do it and change your prayer life. Oh Lord God, strengthen your church in the midst of the current waves of persecution and send us help from your holy place. Have a wonderful day, and God bless you. Bye-bye.
This robe of flesh I'll drop and rise to see.